All right, so we're discussing the upcoming week, week two of the EPL. Some big games coming up this weekend, gents. Obviously, the biggest one of all, Man City, and the defending champions, Chelsea.
I mean, the whole thing.
Defending champions, Chelsea.
It goes together.
We'll pay that homage. Another big game. I think we need to look at gents is Spurs versus Stoke. That's a really big game. Southampton Everton is a tough game, and obviously you are away at Aston Villa. Is that a concern?
It should be.
No.
just by looking at the way you guys are playing, that should be a concern for you guys.
We're gonna see. We're gonna clarify. Listen, we bought a kid with legs like a racehorse, Depay. He just needs to start racing. He just needs to start racing at them. Here's the thing, here's what you guys don't get. The boy from Newcastle showed it to us. Wingers from Holland are well trained. They know what they're doing. I dislike the fact that Van Gaal is starting behind Rooney, in all honesty. But then again, who am I to stand up against Van Gaal? You know how Van Gaal acts. But I would say I'd love to see Depay coming in with the wing. For a few reasons. If Montero can do it, I think Depay is a better player than Montero. I feel like Depay would really threaten right backs. Okay. And if you've got Depay on the one side,
is it a game you're hoping to win?
Of course! Listen, as this man said confidently, I want to win every game.
Okay.
But I'm away from home.
Yes. Exactly.
So I'm definitely taking it with a pinch of salt, but we have to win. We have to win against Aston.
Alright, let's come to you guys. Big game.
With City.
Of course, City. You just saw what they did. They just annihilated.
Yeah, against West Brom.
Are we? Oh, we are without Thibaut Courtois.
Yes.
Without Begovic. Thibaut Courtois. We got Begovic. Begovic could easily start for United.
Well,
Begovic could easily start for
stop. Don't go.
No, I mean.
No, yeah, just don't.
If you guys didn't get Che, then you go like this. Begovic is a class keeper.
That's true.
So there's certain confidence. And an interesting thing actually is that I was reading some article where they were comparing goalkeepers, top clubs with their goalkeepers. The top clubs don't really need an exceptional goalkeeper, they just need a really good goalkeeper. Because we have a good defense. How many saves is Begovic gonna have to make, for instance, you know? So and how many times will our goal be threatened? So Begovic, I'm very happy with him.
Do you think Mourinho is going to do what we expect Mourinho to do, which is put Zuma and match him with Matic and go defend? Is he going to take the point he came in with?
He's going to put 10 players behind the
play. Why would you say that?
Because that's Mourinho's way. He's away from home.
Away from home without his star keeper.
He started off with one shot against West Brom.
I think that's another issue for another day, but given how we played against Swansea, the spaces that we afforded to Gomez,
even Ayew, I think
Ayew, like we're wide open. So I think he'll have to tighten up, because nothing from last week's display suggests that we should go to the Etihad and be expansive, right? But
would you be happy with the point at Man City?
With the point?
Yeah.
Again, no.
I don't want to talk about City because I hate them. But I will say, it was scary how many doubts that was ticking. Torre was ticking.
Wilfred was ticking.
Aguero came in and he was ticking. But I'm looking. This could potentially be a great game because City's defense, for me, doesn't foster any kind of confidence. I mean, Sanya.
Mangala.
Which is a.
That's a freeway.
I think Hazard could do damage. Willian could definitely do damage.
I was impressed with Willian. He's impressed me considering the type of players.
But let's ask I'm going to Crystal Palace.
Yeah, you're going to Pudgy?
It's gonna be a tough game. It's gonna be a tough game, but one thing I know about Mourinho is we respond well.
After
the loss, our response is a win. That's I'm that confident that Wenger's gonna come home with 3 points.
But isn't that one of Arsenal's biggest problems, or that you're reactive? We first have to lose a couple of games, drop a couple of points, and then go on this amazing run of 13 games without a loss, kind of thing. How does that make you feel? As
so, so listen, we had to make sacrifices in the
Was it for the stadium? Was it worth it?
Listen, we now have one of the best stadiums in the world. We now ranked as one of the top richest teams in the world.
One of the most expensive tickets.
What Arsenal's done in the space of 10 years with what we had is undeniable. Gents, you can't deny that it's magic.
No one else can except the
Listen, in this team. Yeah, listen, two seasons ago, I have two FA Cups back to back. I'm the most successful FA Cup winner today. Am I not?
Is that where we
are? I haven't dropped. No, it's not where we are, gents. I'm trying to make a point that I haven't dropped out of the top four in 19 years. Show some respect.
Both of you guys haven't seen top four. Like, where have you been?
You've been in and out. I'm saying I've been constant. I'm the only constant top four side. I'm saying yes, you're right. It is a concern that we make stupid mistakes, and I think it's a difference between us and the other top four sides. Is even when you guys play bad, doesn't necessarily mean that you lose. Mm-hmm. When we do play bad,
it's
we
terrible.
Okay, gents, let's quote it then. Predictions for the weekend. I'll start with you, Sam.
I think
Manu, Villa.
I think Rooney hits his straps. I think I'm expecting a 3-0.
3-0, clean sheet.
Who's scoring
away? Away. Rooney hits his straps. I started with
Rooney hat trick. So it's a Rooney hat trick. So that's
Rooney.
A fantasy tip.
Rooney brace. Depay scores one.
Okay, no. Predictions from your side, Chelsea?
From my side, I think it would be a cagey affair. So I'll go with a 2-1 to City with a Hazard goal and an Oscar goal.
So you're tipping a Luis for your side?
No, I said a Hazard goal.
Yeah.
And then Oscar.
So Chelsea.
You said City. When we're the defending champion.
He said City, and I heard
he
it. So you know what's happened in his head.
Chelsea
fans all want to see the blood from this guy. They definitely want to see the slaughter.
It's a definite 3-1.
3-1.
Against the Podge side.
Different goal scorers.
Against the Podge side.
Of course.
But Podge is doing wonders. Crystal Palace.
What do you mean? And? Like.
What's your point? Yeah, you're right. Because West Brom West Ham didn't beat you guys.
West Ham was an exception. And we just played back. And hence I said, because we are on a response, we're coming there to respond.
Is it
going to be on the front foot?
I might give it to him for one reason, because Santi's coming back.
Ramsey, Santi,
Sanchez.
Those are all the goals that come
back. Yeah. So Sanchez back, I think, outside the difference.
3-1.
3-1.
You're right, but I suppose Arsenal, you guys have a good track record against small teams, so it's, suppose, not outside the realm of possibility.
I say is good luck to you guys. Please keep dropping points and I'll keep taking them.
No, I don't need anyone to drop points.
Well, let's see what happens.
I want to beat you at your base.
Chance.
United won the league in 2011. I'm the best or the worst. No. You must be at your base. So I must beat you at your base.
This is what I'm saying. I'm going to keep my points. I know you're dropping points this week.
Mark my words, you are dropping points.
And actually, a point will be a gift. I think that's that.
I think you might walk away with a point, but
that'll be a great gift.
2-1 to Chelsea. Yes.
Call it.
I'm going to call it with these boys. Guys, join us again next week as we review the results of the weekend's games.
Cheers.
But never, Jenny.